What's up, guys? Velociraptor here, and Jurassic Revolution is finally out. Yay! I pre-ordered it, so yeah, let's start.
Hello. May I say welcome? My name is Dr. Ian Malcolm. You may have heard of me. Well, correction, you should have heard of me, especially now that you're here. So before you are the islands that you need to manage, if you can. Five deaths. Jeez, if only there had been five. Okay, this is as good a place as any to begin. Isla Matanceros. It's relatively stable. Yeah, you can get your feet wet here, and you should, because diving into the deep end of the pool is where the big, angry, hungry things are. And you want to be ready before you try that.
Whoa.
I'm Kevin Finch, public relations and crisis management, and I'm here to help you. You'll start by building a Hammond creation lab.
This is amazing.
I've already started on an enclosure for you. You should just attach it to the side. But watch out for dinosaurs. Just kidding.
Alright, let's place this here.
Let's focus on what you're here to do, which is create dinosaur facilities on the islands we call the Five Deaths. Actually, Las Cinco Muertes. Because Spanish is the lingo of choice around here. You'll need to connect it to the pre-existing network of paths and the power grid. Now comes the real test, incubating a dinosaur. You'll start with a struthiomimus. Select the creation lab and pick a hatchery bay. There's enough genome data for your first viable dinosaur.
The machinations of the ambitious, undoing extinction, playing with nature's laws. What can possibly go wrong?
Come on, Doctor. You know we've learned so much and invested even more in our Jurassic operations since the last time.
Yes, Mr. Finch, yes, the last time. There's always a last time. And a next.
Oh my god, our first dinosaur. This is amazing. Alright, get ready. 3, 2, 1. Oh god, oh no. Okay, there we go.
The most precious moment. The result of incalculable actions, reactions, trials and errors.
Oh, it's beautiful.
Mutations and unknowable combinations, chaos, all leading to a living, breathing, thinking being, an entity, distinct and unique. And now you, just manufacture them. So, well done, I guess.
It's beautiful.
The Hammond Foundation has three main areas of interest.
Security, okay, there it goes.
Entertainment and science. I've already nudged the heads of each division to reach out to you personally. They'll offer opportunities and incentives for you to be part of their team. Choose one of their contracts. It'll help you develop your facility.
Let's do science? Yeah, let's go with science.
Ah, Dr. Dua. This is our new Director of Operations.
I'm aware, Cabot. I'm Dr. Dua. I run the science division of our operation. Okay, you're going to need to build your reputation in the science division. Not easy with me around, but your knowledge. That means managing our dinosaur population and seeing that they are flourishing.
contracts can be requested from the division heads inside the control room. Complete these to increase your reputation and gain additional revenue to keep expanding your park.
Oh my god, it's drinking. Right, how do I do this? Alright, operations. Let's just like put it right in here. Alright, I wanna put it here.
So, one more thing. Your reputation. Your rep, quote unquote. Keep an eye on it, okay? If you have a solid reputation with a division, you're more likely to benefit from them. Financially, I mean. But, like life, it's a balancing act. Each division is vying for your attention, and if they don't get it, they tend to take it personally.
Are these workers? Oh, I think they are. Neat.
People think money makes the world go round, but they're wrong. Contracts make the world go round, my friend. Obligations and commitments. Complete a contract, and your rep with the science division will increase. Meaning, you'll be able to take on more complex and challenging missions.
Where should we send our expedition team?
An expedition center will allow you to send dig teams around the world in search of new dino fossils. DNA can be extracted from these fossils, which our scientists can then turn into living, breathing dinosaurs. And that's our true lifeblood.
I've got an interesting opportunity for you to consider. It will allow us to work together to create life. Pure life. If you've been listening to Dr. Malcolm, then you know how important this is to us. And to me. I knew you were my kind of person. Inquisitive, driven, and I knew you couldn't resist this opportunity. So let's get started.
I'm gonna name this,
Together, we can create a more authentic
version
of our dinosaurs.
Popcorn.
Complete genome. I think you are up to the challenge. Don't disappoint.
Good! Your first expedition team is out. They'll bring back what they find to the fossil center for extraction.
Oh, gives like facts? It's amazing.
Your job is simple. Create dinosaurs, which attract visitors to your facilities, brings in capital, money, which means you can do more research to build better facilities and create more dinosaurs, and there you go. A circle of life, development and resources, nature and commerce. See? Simple.
Let's extract the goalies. Yeah. Oh my god, rain! It's raining! It's raining! Oh, this is beautiful! Oh, hi, Popcorn! Hi! You liking it here? Cool.
From fossils that have been collected inside your fossil center. That will increase the amount of viable data you have to create dinosaurs.
Look at all these dinosaurs. Look at them. Oh yeah, Spinosaurus. Okay. How much money do we have? Oh, we have a lot, yeah. I'm gonna get another one of these. So Popcorn can have a buddy. Where is he? Popcorn, where'd you go? Where'd you go, Popcorn? There he is. Are you happy? I'm gonna give it a herbivore feeder.
Dinosaurs require different diets. Make sure to place the correct type of feeder in an enclosure. I'm a red meat man myself.
Oh, a new one. Cool.
The research center lets you improve your park in various exciting ways. New buildings, upgrades, and more await.
Let's do a generic item upgrades. Alpine? Oh, this is like changing your skin color. New viable genome.
We are making
this release another one.
I believe I may be on the cusp of something. And I have you to thank, at least in part, for where I find myself. Now we need to incubate, hatch, and house our dinosaur. Then we will know if our efforts will have been worth it. A Struthiomimus. Interesting. Another dinosaur that furthers the case of a direct linkage to our modern birds.
Yeah, let's get Triceratops in here. Alright, Triceratops is incubating.
seen things I'd rather not talk about, but it hasn't dampened my commitment to the dinosaurs. Raptors, more generally, and me and Blue specifically. We have a special relationship, like what I have with Claire. Less complicated. Anyway, nice to meet you.
All right, let's turn on the light. It's beautiful. Restaurant.
Our new specimens, sorry, dinosaurs, are meeting expectations, but we want them to thrive. That's your next assignment. Making sure our specimens are properly cared for. In other words, dinosaur welfare.
The difference with dinosaurs is that they have no point of reference to understand humans, so don't expect much in the way of thank yous.
I've been monitoring what you've been up to with great interest, and I'm a little disappointed that Dr. Dua came to you for this assignment instead of bringing me into the loop as she should have done. I'll discuss this with her.
Alright, so we have two Struthiomimus and a Triceratops. Alright, I'm gonna end it off here. Stay tuned for part two, guys. Hope you enjoy.
This is Lambert, head of.
Alright, let's just let this play out.
Yours, theirs, and mine. Welcome to the islands. So here's our basic conundrum. We want to keep our animals under control while simultaneously encouraging instinctive behaviors. Because these animals have potential as combatants. Look, everyone's fair object, myself included, is to have these animals running free and loose in the park. But we can't exploit them globally without taking some chances.